Welcome to a code report solution video. In this video, we're going to be covering the solution to the problem entitled Chef and an ideal problem from the CodeChef December 2018 long challenge. The problem states, Chef likes probability puzzles a lot, almost as much as interactive problems. Today, he learned about the Monty Hall paradox. Suppose that Chef is participating in a game show where he has to choose between three doors numbered 1 through 3. There is a car behind one of the doors and goats behind the other two. Chef does not know what is behind which door, but there is a game host who knows where the car is. First, you need to help Chef pick a door. Let's denote it by X. Then the host opens a different door. Let's denote it by Y. Such that there is a goat behind this door, and asks Chef to pick an arbitrary door again. Let's denote it by Z. You need to help Chef pick door Z too. You should do it in a way such that the probability of a car being behind door Z is maximized. If there are multiple optimal possible ways to pick doors for Chef, you may choose any one. And the constraints for this problem are that Y is going to be between 1 and 3 inclusive, and X is not going to be equal to Y. And as I mentioned in the first problem that I covered from this contest, interactive problems require you to flush your output once you've finished outputting something and you want to input something. So in between outputting and inputting, you need to flush. And the three different ways to do this for C++, Java, and Python are as follows. So there's details and links in the description to link to different blogs that talk about this if you need help with that. So let's take a look at the example that CodeChef provided us with for this problem. So here it is. It's just a back and forth, I guess, twice. So initially, you output your first guess. In this guess, we've chosen door number 3. And then the grader opens door number 1, and then you choose door number 2. So for those of you familiar with the Monty Hall paradox, you obviously know the logic behind this. But for those that are not, instead of myself explaining it, let's take a look at a clip from the movie 21 that was released a number of years ago.
All right, now, let's give Ben a chance for some extra credit, shall we? We're going to call this the game show host problem, all right? Ben, suppose you're on a game show, and you are given a chance to choose from 3 different doors, all right? Now, behind one of the doors is a new car. Behind the other two, goats. Which door would you choose, Ben?
Door number 1.
Door number 1. Ben chooses door number 1. All right, now, the game show host, who, by the way, knows what's behind all the other doors, decides to open another door. Let's say he chooses door number 3, behind which sits a goat. Now, Ben, game show host comes up to you and says, Ben, do you want to stay with door number 1 or go with door number 2? Now, is it in your interest to switch your choice?
Yeah.
Well, wait. Remember, the host knows where the car is, so how do you know he's not playing a trick on you, trying to use reverse psychology to get you to pick a goat?
Well, I wouldn't really care. I mean, my answer's based on statistics, based on variable change.
Variable change? Well, you just asked you a simple question.
Yeah, but you changed everything.
Enlighten us.
Well, when I was originally asked to choose a door, I had a 33.3% chance of choosing right. But after he opens one of the doors and then reoffers me the choice, it's now 66.7% if I choose to switch. So, yeah, I'll take door number 2, and thank you for the extra 33.3%.
Exactly. People, remember, if you don't know which door to open, always account for variable change. Now, see, most people wouldn't take the switch out of paranoia, fear, emotions. But Mr. Campbell, he kept emotions aside and let simple math get his ass into a brand new car.
So hopefully that makes sense. The gist of it basically is that whatever door the individual, the show host, opens, you want to choose the other one because it's going to be twice as likely. There's going to be a 66% chance versus a 33% chance that the car is behind that door. So knowing that, we can go ahead and take a look at our solutions. So here is our C++ solution. The way we're doing this is that we're always going to guess number one is our first guess, and then based on what we get back, we're either going to guess three or two. So we output one, then we do our flush, which takes place in our end line, and then we read in x, and if x is equal to 2, we output 3, otherwise output 2. And that's all there is to it. So really this is more of a tricky problem in terms of figuring out what you need to guess, but even if you don't know about the Monty Hall problem, you might have been able to figure that out just by looking at the example. So moving on to our Java solution, as always, it's a little bit more verbose, but we're doing the exact same thing, outputting 1, then flushing our output, then reading in x, and then based on x, outputting 3 or 2. And last but not least, our Python solution, the most concise of all of them, once again, outputting 1, flushing our output, reading in x, and then based on that, outputting either 2 or 3. And the time complexity for this problem is going to be constant due to the fact that all we're doing is a simple operation based on what we read in.
As always, if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, hit that like button. If you want to see more, make sure to hit that subscribe button. You can follow me on Twitter for reminders 30 minutes before contests start, and you can find all of the code shown in my videos on my GitHub page. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.